Welcome to the PV online course on grid-connected PV system. This chapter is called Electrical Characteristics of a Solar Cell. In this particular teaching unit, we will deal with the influence of temperature and irradiance on the JV characteristic of a solar cell. To understand how a change in temperature or irradiance affects the electrical behavior of a solar cell, let's look at both effects separately. Let's start with the irradiance and an influence on the short circuit current density. In an ideal solar cell without losses, all incident photons with sufficient energy generate electron hole pairs. If the number of photons double, the number of electron hole pairs also doubles. Therefore, for the ideal solar cell, there's a linear relationship between the photocurrent and the irradiance. Since the short circuit current corresponds to the photocurrent, the short circuit current density also increases linearly with the irradiance. We indicate this linear relationship here with a constant C0. As you can see, a change in irradiance also affects the open circuit voltage. With increasing irradiance, the open circuit voltage also increases, but less than the short circuit current. Let's examine this effect in more detail. At the beginning of this chapter, we derived an equation for the open circuit voltage for an ideal solar cell. We have seen that the open circuit voltage depends on the temperature voltage and the logarithm of the photocurrent divided by the reverse saturation current. We assume that only the irradiance changes, not the temperature. The temperature voltage and the reverse saturation current density are not influenced by the irradiance. The photocurrent, however, as we've just seen, is proportional to the irradiance. For the open circuit voltage, therefore, there's a logarithmic dependence on the irradiance, which we represent here with the constant C1. Let us now also look at the influence of irradiance on efficiency. In the first teaching unit of this chapter, we defined the efficiency of a solar cell as follows. So the efficiency is linearly related to the short circuit current and the open circuit voltage. For simplicity, we assume that the fill factor remains constant as the irradiance changes. We have just shown that the short circuit current increases proportionally with irradiance, and the open circuit voltage increases proportionally with the logarithm of the irradiance. Let's put these relations into the formula for the efficiency. This term can be simplified. We can eliminate the irradiance and summarize all the constant in a constant C2. So we see that the efficiency of a solar cell is proportional to the logarithm of the irradiance. What is the significance of this relationship for the behavior of a solar cell? To answer this question, we plot the efficiency against the irradiance. According to the relationship just derived, we get a logarithmic curve. The curve shown here relates to a constant cell temperature at 25 degrees C. It was calculated using the single diode model for a commercial solar module. In the data sheet of the solar module, the efficiency is given as 22.6%. We can see that this efficiency is only reached at an irradiation of 1000 watt per square meter. In Central Europe, this corresponds to the irradiation at midday on a clear summer sky. As the irradiance decreases, the efficiency drops significantly. For the operation of solar systems, this behavior can be significant if low irradiance values are frequently present. For example, the frequency of irradiance below 300 watt per square meter in Cologne, in Germany, is 30%. Now, let's regard what happens when the temperature of the solar cell increases. First, we look at the effect on the short circuit current. In the diagram shown here, you can see the JV curve at different cell temperatures. Note that these do not correspond to the ambient temperature, since a solar cell usually heats up during operation and is therefore usually warmer than the ambient. We can see that the short circuit current increases slightly as the temperature increases. But what is the reason for this? Well, it is because the band gap EG of the semiconductor material becomes smaller with increasing temperature due to the oscillations of the crystal lattice. As a result, photons with a little lower energy can also be absorbed and lift electrons from the valence to the conduction band. Therefore, the number of charge carriers increases and the short circuit current increases linearly. In contrast to the irradiance, however, a doubling of the temperature does not lead to a doubling of the short circuit current. The dependence of the short circuit current on the temperature is described by the temperature coefficient alpha. For a crystalline silicon solar cell, it is about 0.0 milliamps per square centimeter per degree Kelvin. Usually, alpha is related to the short circuit current at STC conditions. That means at 1000 watt per square meter and 25 degrees Celsius cell temperature, and is given in percent per Kelvin. Typical values of alpha in silicon are 0.05% per Kelvin. The short circuit current at any other temperature can be calculated using the following formula. Note that the temperature coefficient alpha applies only to the short circuit current. A linear dependence on temperature can also be determined for the MPP current, but this results in a different temperature coefficient. Let us now regard the influence of the temperature on the open circuit voltage. We can see in the diagram that the temperature has a much stronger effect on the open circuit voltage than it has on the short circuit current. Let's take a look on why this is so. If we consider the formula for the open circuit voltage, at first glance we might think that the open circuit voltage increases with increasing temperature due to the temperature voltage. But this is not the case, which is due to the reverse saturation current density. The reverse saturation current density describes the current generated by thermally generated electron hole pairs. It increases exponentially with increasing temperature. As a result, VOC decreases as the temperature T increases. Just as with the short circuit current, a linear dependence on temperature can be derived for the open circuit voltage. This dependence again is described by temperature coefficient. For the open circuit voltage, it is denoted by beta. Beta indicates the change in open circuit voltage per degree Kelvin. Beta is also usually related to the open circuit voltage at STC and given in percent per Kelvin. Since the open circuit voltage decreases with increasing temperature, beta always has a negative value. Typical values for silicon solar cells are about minus 2.2 millivolt per Kelvin or minus 0.35% per Kelvin. Again, note that the temperature coefficient refers only to the open circuit voltage. A linear relationship can also be established for the MPP voltage, but here a different coefficient would be needed. Due to the strong drop of the open circuit voltage with increasing temperature, the power in the MPP also decreases. A temperature coefficient can also be specified for the MPP power. For silicon solar cell, this is about minus 0.4 to minus 0.5% per Kelvin. That means with a temperature increase of 10 degrees, the power of a solar cell or a solar module thus decreases by about 4 to 5% of the nominal power. We can use the temperature coefficients to calculate the short circuit current and open circuit voltage at any operating conditions. If the short circuit current is known for a certain cell temperature T1 and irradiance E1, the following equation can be used to calculate the short circuit current I2 at a different temperature T2 and irradiance E2. The dependence on the temperature is described by the temperature coefficient alpha. The dependence on irradiance is linear. Similarly, the open circuit voltage can be calculated for any conditions if the open circuit voltage VOC1 is known at temperature T1 and irradiance E1. Here the dependence on temperature is described by the temperature coefficient beta. For the irradiance, we had found a logarithmic influence. This influence is additionally modulated by the dimensionless correction factor zeta. Zeta is about 0.06 or 6% for crystalline silicon solar cells. These equations will play a significant role later if we need to consider the system's performance at different outdoor temperatures when designing an inverter for a system. Finally, let us consider the influence of the temperature on the efficiency of a solar cell. In the diagram shown here, the influence of temperature and irradiance on the efficiency are illustrated. Due to the linear decrease of the MPP power, the efficiency also decreases linearly with the temperature. It can be seen that at high irradiances, the influence of temperature on efficiency is predominant, while at low irradiance, the influence of irradiance is stronger. Let's summarize. With increasing irradiance, ISC increases proportionally and VOC increases logarithmically. With increasing temperature, ISC increases slightly while VOC drops sharply. Overall, a higher irradiance leads to a higher efficiency and a higher temperature to a lower efficiency. I thank you for your attention.